dignity. You see what that does for personhood? That she would decorate her toilet even better than a house. 133 beneficiaries, direct beneficiaries, from just 21 toilets. 133 persons who would have been using somewhere otherwise. 133 persons who no longer have to hold the feces and cause other health problems. 133 persons who can no longer get in conflicts with neighbors because plastic bags of feces are falling on the veranda. Because as simple as it sounds and as funny as it sounds, shit in communities like these can cause breakouts of violence. Because people would fight you for sure shit in them.
Maybe they know shit.
Pun well intended.
Or your dog drive over.
Or your dog drive over. So we did some breakdown in terms of gender analysis. 59% of the beneficiaries are females. 41% are males. And let me just clarify this even a bit more. The 41 who are males are not necessarily head of the households. They're just males who live in the households. 90% of our overall beneficiaries are females. It's saying something to us. That our women and girls are disproportionately affected by issues of improper sanitation. They're the ones being labeled dirty gal. They're the ones who, without a safe space to relieve themselves, are open to rape and molestation. So when we think sanitation, we also have to think along gender lines and gender rights. We also have to think along violence.
They're also the ones who will socialize the next generation.
Ah, important point. Because really, it was the mothers, even though the men were going to shit in the toilet too, it was really the women who came out and brought the children to the participatory training that you saw a picture of. And they were the ones teaching other people, teaching their neighbors. That even if the neighbor doesn't have the toilet, the neighbor isn't throwing anymore. Because they're sharing their new toilet with those who don't have.
There's a